This video is sponsored by I Put the Egg on the Sulaco. It Was Me t-shirt. Check it out at the viral store. Why did the engineers create the Xenomorphs? Why, Mr. Anderson? Why'd you do it? Was that David created the Xenos? Well, maybe Xeno XX121, which is the classic alien. But let's think back to Prometheus, which takes place before Alien Covenant, and take a look at the Xeno mural in particular, which features a Deacon, I think. So the engineers have obviously created Xenomorph species like the Deacon well before the classic alien XX121. At the start of the movie, we witness an engineer sacrifice himself with the black liquid pathogen. His body disintegrates, and it's suggested this process creates new life on the planet. Was it planet Earth? Well, most likely. It appears that a small amount of black goo results in mutation, as witnessed in Holloway and Fifield, whereas a large amount results in complete disintegration. Yeah, make sure you dose the black goo carefully, kids. Let's take a look at more evidence. The derelict in Alien was definitely transporting the Xenomorph eggs as weapons, just as the ship in Prometheus was transporting the urns. So here's our first piece of evidence, that the space jockeys did indeed use alien eggs, no doubt for the creation of chestbursters as weapons. Or maybe he was transporting them to an engineer pet shop, I don't know. Prometheus makes it unclear just how long they've been using xenomorphs as weapons, and when they decided to replace the black liquid with eggs, since there's such a short time frame between Prometheus and Alien, and it's not even a xenomorph that comes out of the engineer. Then again, the ship in Prometheus was thousands of years old and inactive. This Deacon could be an isolated incident and probably wasn't the first of its kind. The derelict, however, may have been active for a much longer time before its pilot unfortunately turned into a host. Xenomorph eggs may have become the standard by this time. The space jockey may have landed on a then remote planet, LV-426, because he knew he was going to die, which is why it looks like he settled into his chair and had his suit merge into it. Why he didn't contact anyone about his infection is also a big mystery. He was either the only crew member aboard the ship, or the only one left. The engineers in Prometheus had also been victims of chestbursters, except one had survived. As soon as he wakes up, he decides to take out the Prometheus team and carry on his mission to destroy all life on Earth, probably because he didn't like some of the creatures he accidentally created. So what was going to happen to Earth if the engineer did make it? Well, I guess Alien Covenant explains that bit pretty well. Basically, what David did to the engineer city. What's that? They aren't engineers, but simple peasants? And the real engineers are going to take revenge? We shall see. I guess the big question is, was the engineer intending to destroy life on Earth using the black goo or the xenomorphs? Well, maybe both. The black goo is released on the population and vaporizes life forms in its immediate vicinity. This is stage one. The second stage is the neomorph spores, which spawn from the disintegrated bodies. The neomorph spores infect the remaining survivors, killing them when the neomorphs are born. The neomorphs then go on to take out anything else left on the planet. Makes sense, right? Well, the Xenomorph XX121 would be a more effective killing machine than the neomorphs. And I guess Alien Awakening will explain how David tweaked the xenomorph design to create the biomechanical creature we all know and fear today. But some of us are really hoping this isn't the case. It just removes the mystery of the creature. This is why I hate prequels in general. I really didn't need to know what Vader did when he was 8 and how he got the scars. You wanna know how I got these scars? I don't need to know about the space jockey and the derelict in Alien. Let's face it, the space jockey was supposed to be an elephant-like creature, which Ridley then made into a suit containing an albino. We all know it was supposed to be an elephant alien thing, and you made it into a suit, okay? Simple as that, guys. Anyway, what do you reckon? Why did the engineers create the xenomorphs?
Why, Mr. Anderson? Why'd you do it?
Please let me know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe and like the video. Also, please follow me on Twitter. And if you enjoyed this video and want to see more, consider supporting me on Patreon. Oh, and make sure you click the bell icon to turn on notifications. I'll see you later.